We get so excited to, you know, get you on board to understand how to glamorize the African fashion. Because it's so beautiful, it's so glamorous, it's full of whatever you want to call it. We are here to support you, to guide you, to help you bring out the most beautiful, elegant side of you. So my name is Joy Fido, and our side of business that we talk to you about this African fashion is called the African Couture Fashion. So welcome on board, and what I'm going to do, you can see me all dressed up in my beautiful Gele, and I'm wearing my Iro Buba. So I want to take you backwards to show you how I achieved this look. Okay, so this is what we're going to be wearing today. Now the African fashion, the beauty about the African fashion is about color, and it's all about color coordination. So if you've been watching some of the videos we've done on the African fashion, you find out I create particular images. So one day it could be red. So it's all about color coordination and the different schemes that you bring on board. So we've done red, we've done white, we've done blue, and we've done yellow, and so many colors can come in. Now this is the beauty of the African fashion. This is what I absolutely love about it. The fact that you can really glow and come out with whatever color scheme you're thinking of. It's not dark, it's not boring, it's not blurry. And so today we're working on green. And this green is gonna be accessorized in so many different ways. Now what I tend to do is, I may decide that today's coordination will be with silver or with gold, and depending on what I decide, or beads. So depending on what I decide on going with it, I then create things that coordinate with that. So if you notice, the necklace is got hints of green in it, and the earring is matching slightly with the necklace. So this is how I play with it. Now this particular necklace set has its own earring, but it's a bit small, and I tend to like the really long dangling earrings when I dress up in my, you know, traditional outfit. So I've taken another necklace that's got similar, I mean earring that's got similar look with the necklace, and that's why I'm coordinating them like that. And then I'm gonna bring rings that will match with them in a way, so you're not seeing too many color clashing like gold and silver. Now the reason I used a bit of a silver in the brooch is because the color of gold combination that I had was blending straight into the green. It had a green, you know, design in it, and it was surrounded with gold, and so it was gonna just sit inside the head tie, and you would not have noticed the difference. So I thought, no, I'll bring something that stands differently so you can at least notice that there's a brooch on the head. So these are the kind of things you do when you're trying to dress in a traditional outfit to make you really stand out and look great. So that's mainly what our focus is going to be on today. So I'll be taking you through how I'm bringing the necklace, and I'm bringing the gold, or not gold, but the gold colored necklace or gold fashion necklace, and you know, the rings, and you know, tying the wrapper, so you again get to know how the wrapper is tied. And then you can see the shoe blending in as well. So if you notice what I've done, I've just worn the top. And the next stage for me now is to tie the wrapper, which is what I'm holding. But I'll show you something really beautiful about this wrapper. Now, normally when they make these wrappers, we just make a straight hemi and then you just get a straight end. But this particular one, they went a step further, and they created like a hint of flared ends. So it just gives the wrapper a look of you're wearing a really long skirt. When I tie this, I'll show you what that means. But going further down, you can see that I'm wearing leggings. Now the reason for that is so that I have something that covers, that my wrapper is not seen through my underwear. And this is one way I have decided to work with this. Obviously based on the environment that I'm based, which is always very cold. So if you're going out to an African party and you have to dress like this, you may be feeling cold underneath, because most times the fabrics are so flimsy and see-through. This is one of those ones that is not really much see-through. Some of them have like really big holes in them, the lace fabric, and so you're really, really cold. So I came out having to wear leggings, so it makes I'm warm inside, and then I can still look as glamorous as I want to be. So that's one way of doing it. And in one of the videos, I had told you I was going to show you another way we do it. So today I'm going to show you another thing that we actually put on back in Africa. So this is what it is. It's a slip. Okay, so this is the slip, which I just showed you now. So normally you just put your leg through it. It's like a regular skirt, but it's just a smaller, shorter skirt. Sometimes you get them really long. And so that's you with your slip on. So in this particular case, you notice I've got my leggings underneath. So I got the leggings and I got the slip. And so I'm going to get my wrapper now and I'm going to tie it. Okay, so this is my wrapper, or Iro as the Yorubas would call it. So now I'm ready to tie it. And if you look further down, you can see the effect of the flared design that was created at the base of this. Okay, so I'm going to start tying it now. Now, two things could happen. You see this piece that I've got? You need one of these whenever you know that you're going to be tying wrapper from time to time. There's so many different lengths you could get them for. You could get them in different colors. Now, normally when you get your fabric sewn for your traditional outfit, just say nicely to your tailor or your seamstress, could I have one of those pieces that I can use in tying my wrapper? They're absolutely useful and necessary, because you don't want to go out and then you tie what you think you've tied, and then you get embarrassed because it just fell off. Not all the time would your sleeve be the best looking sleeve. Even if it's beautiful, somehow we have a feeling of feeling naked if we find our sleeve just hanging out. So you need one of these to help you. Now the beauty of this particular one is it was attached. So this is attached to the fabric, and so you don't necessarily need a different piece. So those are choices. You can have it attached to your fabric, or you can get a different piece. I usually prefer having a different piece, because that way I always have something that works for me. Okay, so remember our tutorial on how to tie the wrapper, or the Iro as we will call it. Leg has to be opened. And the good reason for opening the leg is to avoid it getting stuck, like when you want to walk. Now I'll show you a little trick. If you kept your leg like that and you tied your wrapper, what happens is when you tie it, it's held you down. And if you try to walk, you get so tight you can't really walk in them. So this is something I was taught way back when I was a little child, and I used to be so curious when my aunties who open their leg when they're tying up. I'm like, why are you opening your leg? Because you need the space. So by opening your leg, you need space for you to walk. And so you get one angle of it, which is the smaller angle, and you lift that directly to the other side. Hold it down and hold it down really tightly. Then you bring the other side across. Something you have to watch out for is the base down there. When you're trying to tie the one side, lift that base really high up, so that when you bring this second side, it blocks it. Because if you didn't lift it up, what will happen is that side will be still down and this one goes over it. So I've lifted the inner side of the wrapper. Remember, there are two sides. One goes in and one goes over. So the one that's inside is the one that I have to lift really high up, so that, again, it gives me space to walk in and does not sit on the knee that's come from the one that's coming from over it. So that one comes and sits over it. And now you can stand well. So now I'm going to make it sit really firmly on me. And this is where the waist comes in. So you make sure it sits really firmly. Then this is one side and this is the other side. So they go into each other. And you tighten. Tighten again, you feel the action again. Pull it, pull the other side, and it gets really firmly in place. Yes? Now you can take that and just take it around you. Because what this means now is this is definitely held around you, so there's no chance of it dropping off. And once it's done, you can tuck it in. And this is when we now will take, if you wanted to wear your ashoke, this is still a bit loose down there. You can just pull it up nicely. This is when you now get other accessories like the ashoke or the damask, which normally comes in two pieces. And I'll show you what they look like sometimes. This is a piece of ashoke if I wanted to use it. I'm not using this today, but they normally come in two pieces and then you could have them as a throw-on. And some people have a habit of putting it on their waist. Those are choices. But if I was going to use that, I would again coordinate the color and then I'll get a green colored, nicely designed. It could be a plain green or mixed up with other colors. So it coordinates with this. But today I didn't plan on using ashoke or damask. I just want to dress like this. Look how nice. And make you see what it looks like. So you notice, okay, so we've tied it on that side. Remember when I turned my back and I tied it. Now what happens if you tie it and you feel it's right in the middle? Sometimes it would have come a bit to the right. So you want it, usually you want it in the middle of your back. So you just take your fabric and just pull it a bit. And that then allows it to sit right in the middle of your back. So now you're ready. Now remember, the reason we're bringing all these ideas and showing you how to do these different things is because we want to maintain our culture. I know younger people today, even people of my time, never really had family around them that were showing them how to do these things properly. I'm just one of the really lucky few who had aunties and, you know, sister-in-law who were really into tying their wrapper and looking beautiful with the African outfit, and I loved it. So I made it my business to try and find out how it was done. And that's why I'm trying to pass on this knowledge. I'm trying to share this knowledge with the world. With us. Okay, so the reason we're showing this, like I've said, is to pass on this knowledge, to share this skill with as many younger people as possible, because we don't want our fashion to our culture and our way of doing things to disappear because people have gotten so hung up on other people's ways of doing things. For me personally, I could dress in any outfit, try and blend in whatever culture there are, but I never want to forget my own culture, and this is why I do all this. Now the few videos we've done in the past with our traditional outfit has come with amazing responses. People are really glad that I'm doing this and letting them know how to dress in their traditional outfit. And you know, some people, when they're having their wedding, they want to go out to evening parties with their friends in the traditional outfit, and they get so lost. So I don't want people lost. I want to support you. I want to guide you. And this is why I'm doing all this. So all these things that I'm showing you, the color coordination, the laces, the jewelry, we have all of them available here. If you need any help, please feel free to contact us, which will put the email address there. We'll put all the numbers there. We're more than happy to support you to look your best on your special day, especially for weddings or for your special party. It could be anything. And I want us to continue to embrace our culture. It is beautiful. It's glamorous. It makes you stand out. And I've seen images where Beyonce dressed like this. She had amazing Gele on her head. So why do we wait until other people say to us that what we have is good before we appreciate it? So this is where I stand all the time. I want people to appreciate what I stand for. I don't mind standing, you know, appreciating other people's things, but I still want my thing to stand out. And that's why I do all these videos in different forms to make you see what you have that you really don't know you have. And by the way, look at my nails. I got two different nail polish colors. Oh, my daughter did that for me. She started with this, which actually matches with the outfit. Because again, you can decide to do different things. You could wear eyelashes, eyeshadows that blend with your outfit. You know, whichever way you want to do it, I give you the support to really go out there and stand out. So we did that color, then we did that color. So I was still thinking which one's best, but it's just a video, so I'm not really going out with anything at the moment. Okay, so what I've done, I've got the rings. Now, these are entirely up to you, whatever kind of rings you like wearing. I tend to really love gold rings, and I have so many different types, which again, because I love them, I tend to notice them. So I have them for sale, any of these rings plus different designs. I've had people call me as well saying they're interested, and sometimes they're insisting on the exact ones that I have. They're all different designs. So just be creative when you're dreaming how you want your accessories to look like. So these are all bangles, and they come in different designs, different sizes, and different colors. But because remember, our theme today is all about having the gold covered, or gold plated, or gold fashion. So that's what this is all about. You notice my rings are not exactly gold, but then again, I just felt like wearing something a bit different, something bold. And see them? And that also just something in that kind of light. So those are all entirely up to you, what you want to use in accessorizing your outfit. But personally, I love bold outfits. I mean, bold accessories. So some people may find this is not to their taste and they want it really small. It's up to you, whatever makes you happy. But remember, for me, when I try to dress like this, I dress to speak, and my dressing speaks for me. Now, if you notice the wrapper that we tied earlier, remember I told you about how the base has a bit of flare. This is what it looks like. So it looks a bit like a skirt. Now your regular Iro Buba will just be plain straight at the base, but because of the way this is designed, it gives that impression of I'm wearing a long skirt. And that's how this was done. So again, it's up to you if when you tie your wrapper, you decide to change things around. I really welcome that, because we need to be a bit more creative in our outfits so we look different. And then of course a shoe that tends to pick out a bit of the green, being the green focus today. So we're looking at shoes to go with it. So I'm the high heel kind of person. There are people who love to just wear their simple block heels, but for me, the higher the heel, the better. And so that's our complete outfit. We're ready now to rock the town. earrings, necklace, rings, bangles, and then anything else that you want to accessorize your outfit with. Remember we said you could have the damask, which normally comes in two pieces, and you could throw one on and tie one on your waist, or hold one like a handbag. You know, so many different things you could do. So whenever you're dreaming up whatever designs or whatever outfit you want to have and you want me to give you support on that, feel free, email me, call me, let me know, and I'll be there to support you. So what I'm gonna do now is see my beautiful Gele. I absolutely love the way this Gele stood. You know, one side is kind of like slanted. I'm gonna take this off, and then I'm gonna take you through a basic guide on how I achieve this. I get people come in and I'm doing their hair ties, which if you're based here, you can come to me and I'll do it for you. But if you're too far away from me, this is why again we are bringing all this knowledge on, to show you how some of these things could be achieved without you struggling. So, and especially this, the headpiece. This is where you need a lot of support and guidance, because to get the one that really sits straight, which is one of my favorite types, it's really difficult. You could get into the shop and not know what you're looking for. And something I really love about this one is that, see the creativity they put at the tips. These little holes just makes it really stand out. Most of these fabrics I actually had to travel to Switzerland to get them. So it will depend on how important the event is to you and how much you're really willing to put down. Because the beauty about the African fashion is these things don't disappear overnight. They're not things you buy today and tomorrow you've had enough of it. No, these things could last you for years and years and years. So it's very important that when you're buying them, you buy good quality, because they're going to last you for really, really for a long time. Most times, as parents, we'll pass it on to our children. So that's what you could be doing. So when you invest in them, get a really good quality that you can pass on to your children. Okay, so I did promise to show you how I created the head tie. Now, this is the full length of it. And it's not as long as other ones, but it's long enough. So what I've done, the idea today was to create something with a bit of a fold. You can see that. So I folded a side of it, not the full length, I only folded a little side of it, so about 3 folds. Now once you got your fold, you can decide how to put this. I have my wig cap on, so it's covering my natural hair. And then, ideas are you could take it straight on and go like that on your head. That's one way I could have gone with it. And remember, we always have the shorter side near us ready to go. You see how it's slanted? That's the bit that I'm going to be able to tie. So I have that with me, or the particular design I created. Now remember this, whenever you're doing hair tie, if once you do it, you take it out and redo it, you may not get the exact design. It always happens. Something may change, you might pull it a different way, drag it another way. So don't hold me onto it if you don't get the exact design. But I will tell you what I created. So I did that and I took it over my head like that. I didn't go in front, I went. So what I then did, I'm looking in a mirror, so occasionally you see me go this way and I come back to you. So this is the bit I'm going to tie. And so that's gone. So now I come and take the one that I left hanging out. that I've got hanging, I've taken it all the way, all like that, and goes to the back, and now I'm going to connect that to this one. It's holding you really firmly before you go and knot it. Now I'm going to knot this with that. And usually the really, really sharp sides that you knot it with. Okay, so this is a sample of what I've done now. Now remember, one was inside and then I took the other one round it and met up with it and knotted it. That knotting part that can get a bit really, really difficult sometimes. Now why this is being a bit difficult is because I just took out what I've done and the hair tie is still a bit squashed. So you need it to be spread out properly before you can actually achieve quick designs in a section. But because I've already used it, I didn't want to really unravel everything and start all over again, so that's why it's taking a bit longer. But I've been able to have what we call the base. So you get the base, which is the basic. Now what I've got now is not firmly in place, so I've just pushed it like that. And so I'm pushing it to push it to where I want it to be. And this is where the pins come in. And they come in different colors. I love working with them. So I could push it nicely to where I want and then I hold it in place with a pin. And that's what I'm doing right now. So hold it in place, pin them into place. Like that side, I just hold it down with a pin. Now when you're working with the pin, be very careful because they're extremely sharp, just like when you're working with a needle. So this is again where some people have a habit of getting someone to help them, because you don't want to take the chance of putting that pin in the wrong place. And I would normally want to be nearer to the mirror when I'm doing this, because I'm doing a video, so I'm far away from the mirror. I just want to give you a basic idea as much as possible. So that's held in place a little bit. So now you can see the folded bits. Now the folded bits is you actually help yourself to fold it to as much layers as you want it to be. And this is where the very stiff type of fabric really helps. Because when you fold them, they sit in place. You can push your hand in and fold as many times or release as many times as you want to. I'm still trying to get this side to be really firm on me. What I'm going to do, I'll just go by the mirror and push this really in place. So what I've done, I've gone closer to the mirror and I pulled that really firmly. And if you look well, you can see some pins in between. And at the back, I have a pin somewhere there. Somewhere there to really hold it in place. Then, and I took my time, you see that these are all layers. So what I've done, I just drag them down and drag them down. So you can be pulling them down. To create the kind of layered effect you want. And this was what I did with the one I took off. If you see the back. So that's it. And then it starts dropping down. So the more you layer it, the more it hangs down on your side. And you can just play with the layering effect. See that? I could dip my hand in and take it all out. You see how firm it sits. So it's down to you how creative you want to be. And I absolutely love these ones that allow you to play with. I really don't like the soft ones because they don't give me freedom to play. And I love playing with it. I can move this side as well if I want. You see the layers flowing. So that's how they're just dripping themselves up or down, depending on what you want to create. Now, something you've noticed with this one is I've got my knotted bit right here, sticking out really well. See how I pushed it in. The last one I did, it was a lot smaller, and what I did was I used the pin to just hold it down. So these are all unique things that, depending on, most times I find it weird, depending on how I feel at the time. I could get a head tie in seconds, or it could take me a bit longer sometimes. But we've done it. And that's how you can do things like that. Just what I recommend is, if you know you're going out the next day, start playing the day before. And sometimes once you've done it and it's sitting exactly how you want it, you can just take it off. It's like a hat. Just take it off, and then when you're ready for your occasion, you just take it and push it back in, and then, you know, play with the design a bit more. Because this takes time to create. I mean, I'm lucky that I can play with them in seconds. Some people really struggle for hours. So don't give yourself, don't put yourself in that position where you struggle with this. But of course, I'm here. If you're local to me, I'm here and I'm happy to design this and create whatever designs you want for you. What I'm coming up with now is how I can package this, put in a box and send to people depending on where they are. So the more your requests come, the more your demands come, the more I can create amazing things for you. So this is what we've done today. And I hope you liked what we've done today. As usual, email us. We'll put all our information in the description box. Contact us. Let us know how we can help you, especially on this side of things, creating this glamorous look and getting all the jewelry and all the rings. And we're coming up with ideas where we can start stitching and sewing this, the buba, for you, because it's one of those simple things I love doing as well. I've made some for myself, and I may show you hints and tips on how to create them as well, but these are all the ideas that are flowing at the moment. So thank you so much for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in our next video. And stay in touch with us, Joy Fido on Instagram, Joy Fido on Facebook. So I'm going to put all these images from today in there, so you can feel free. We've got people asking us, could I see that picture? Could I see that picture? Feel free, get the pictures, you know, use them, show your friends if they're going to help you create similar design. No problem at all. Joy Fido on Facebook, Joy Fido on Instagram, worldofbraiding on blog, but we haven't started blogging about this. But you know how to reach us. Go on to Google and type in Joy Fido. You see most of the things I've done. And African Couture's Fashion is the site we created on Facebook, where lots of these pictures, you find them. So African Couture Fashion. So see you next time. Thank you.